Yeah, I'm the Phantom Rod, and I tested the lag on this small arcade stick. New Wave Toys released the playable Street Fighter II mini cabinet as part of the Replicate line. New Wave Toys also released a mini stick that's both included in the cabinet as well as a separate SKU. You can get the stick now for $14 as of this video. The design of it is pretty cool with a nice front overlay, replicating the American Street Fighter II cabinet panel art. While the core parts are not Sanwa Denshi, obviously, the lever and push buttons feel alright for what they are. For compatibility, the PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 4 can recognize the stick. The caveat is that depending on game and even legacy controller driver, the stick can range from having misplaced default buttons to input instability. From the games that I've tried, the stick is more or less unusable. It does have its uses though on PC, especially for emulators. Outside of the novelty factor, is the stick good enough to not worry about latency? Let's get out the Arduino lag tester compiled by Wide to analyze the results. The process takes 1000 inputs in rapid succession to determine an average as well as highest and lowest latency inputs. Other information can be found in the spreadsheet down below. The mini stick's native mode pulled for 8 milliseconds, which is a bit higher than the usual 4 milliseconds commonly found nowadays, is outputting an average of 10.5 milliseconds. Its fastest input is at 1.3 milliseconds with the slowest at 19.4 milliseconds. The stick is inputting on frame 39% with the other 61%, triggering a frame afterwards. If you check out the raw data in the stick's results sheet, almost every other input is above 10 milliseconds. If forced to overclock mode, the stick has a pulling rate of 1 millisecond. Even with the highest rate possible, it doesn't improve all that much. On average, it's outputting 8.9 milliseconds with the lowest, recorded at 1.1 milliseconds, and the highest at 16.5 milliseconds. Inputs activate on frame 47% of the time, while the other 53% is happening a frame later. At least in its native mode, the Street Fighter II mini stick is placed more on the lower end of InputLag.Science's results database. It's in line with controllers and sticks such as Hori's PS4 Mini Pad and their PS4 Fighting Stick Mini, the PS3 Guilty Gear Xrd Pad, and the second-gen Sony DualShock 4 when wired. They all have a frame of lag of latency or more on average. Adding a half a frame of lag more in monitors, these devices might not be ideal to use in competition. Not necessarily the worst, but somewhat concerning. I shouldn't have expected Brook-level performance, or even something middling in the end. In a way, after spending $14 and shipping, the stick fulfills the adage of, you get what you pay for. After checking out the very simple PCB inside, the thing is further solidified. If you're using this stick for very casual play, I could definitely see the use of it as well as have a laugh, especially if you have two of them. Spend $14 for one or $28 for a pair to joke around. As something to use very seriously with all things considered, it might be a joke in and of itself. That said, if someone were to win a tournament with the mini stick, even after watching this video, that would be both awesome and hilarious. Until next time, thank you for watching.